been a minute, and this is another breakdown. On May 21st, 2021, KE rappers Crispa, Calligraph, and Matras dropped a massive hit titled Davu Niku. The track is a gem filled with KE pop culture reference, and the beat by Crispa smacks that feel right into the mix of it. But that's just it. The video standard is spectacular in terms of picture quality. What seems like a letdown is the concept of the video. And on today's episode, we will explain why the Davu Niku music video is good, but not that great. My name is Brian Kang, and welcome back to EXP.
First, we start with what is great with the song. The artist combination and flow is phenomenal. Crispa's jokingly serious satire defines the elements of the beat, giving the track an identity. Papa Jones picks up on the flow and broadens it further with more definitive serious satire, making sure to not just throw bars on lazy rap, which is rapping about how great one is to telling a story. Most of the times, such raps never fail to capture people, and this one stands out independently on its own. But Tross understands the assignment at hand and gives this verse a flowy Genge hip hop tone to it, and further makes the track more seriously fun while having a back to back response rap with Crispa. There is chemistry, there are bars, and there are stories tied to the verses. The letdown comes in with a literally empty video. So, before you go hating on me, let me explain what I mean. The picture quality is great. However, it's not the picture quality that's the problem. Rather, the video concept. Now, shooting a video does not just entail having people dance to the track and get featured doing it, but how the video composition in it of itself is a masterpiece. And Davu Niku kinda missed the point on this one. So, by composition, we mean tell a story. I don't mean go full out to simulate the verses and the bars, something Genge Tone was known for back in the day, but have visuals that elaborate the feel and the funk of the track. So, this will mean anything seen is supposed to be seen and not just spotted, but understood and perceived in a highly intentional manner. For a masterpiece like Davu Niku, it lacks just that. Location. The general perception is that a great location will mean that the video will be great. Not necessarily. The aesthetics help give a polished image, but without a concept for the video, it won't mean much. Davu Niku video had an impressive location, but the sort of location that was too huge to utilize and vastly underutilized. The location being huge can be a great thing, but without utilizing it and creating a perception over it, leaves it to mean nothing. Examples of great concepts include Matata featuring Stella on Achu. The video is shot on a central location and a very few talents to actualize the video apart from the artists. Another example would be Nikita Kering with X. The video concept fuses all the other aspects on picture quality, location, and the track itself to form a harmony. Budget. So, before anyone kills me in the comment section with a budget angle, yes, budget is everything, and that's why concept should be there for the sake of a budget. A single location shoot is more dependent on a well-thought-out concept, which also can be a point to make sure that artists get their money's worth in utilizing a location to its full ability. Davu Niku was a shot on a prime piece of real estate, I give you that. Great location, great view, but all we see are rappers, talents, and dancers singing and performing for the camera without a prime order or sequence. Ay-ay-ay. If you think I'm crazy like most people do, what is the difference then between shooting that music video and shooting a TikTok? I'm not hating, just trying to pass the point across.
So let's pull this home. I know I've said a lot of things, and the bottom line is, why do video concepts matter, even in the case of great tracks such as Davu Niku?
So, before you think I'm full of crap, let me cite this example of Nigerian rapper and singer Rema. Yes, I'm citing a Nigerian-based artist. After releasing his track titled Woman, he followed it up with a video befitting the track. The video was a shot on one location, and the rest, the concept kicked in with the help of lighting and dancers who are not dancing to turn up, but aggressively performing. Yes, there is a difference. Video concepts are a huge deal because the video is an art in it of itself, but the depiction of the same is another form of art as well. Sure, yes, Ndavu Niku has over 3 million in views on the tubes. Yes, the track is that good. The point we are making is that quality visuals must meet the standing of the track. That's all. Disclaimer, after this video, some of you might think I don't like the song. I love it. Period. And Calligraph Jones is one of my favorite rappers cause he good and his name, if you didn't know, is Brian. Just in case you missed that point.
This video was produced using independent sources on research and analysis. No company or artist paid a fee for a feature in this video. Also, no party was given any early preview or copy approval, right? And what that means is that they're seeing it for the first time alongside you.
So hey, what do you think of the Ndavu Niku music video? Do you agree with us? Leave a comment on it and share your thoughts with us down below. And hey, do you want to keep up with music breakdowns and listings? Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow us on our social media handles. I'm Brian K on Afropop Explained for the network.